this world today, there are many ways to fall from grace and to go astray. We should realize that in our lives we can make a change for brighter days.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most compassionate. Dear viewers everywhere in the globe, I greet you with the best greeting, the greeting of peace and Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, and peace be unto all of you. Still we are addressing this nice and interesting topic about the two options, a very important theme that really surrounds us all in our life, because every time in our life, every month, every year, every day, every week, perhaps every hour, we confront a situation that we have two options in front of us and we have to select, we have to make the decision. We gave examples from different generations. We gave examples from the messengers of Allah, not only about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Moses and Ibrahim, and we gave examples from the history of humanity, and we give examples of human beings and non-human beings like Iblis. We give examples about men and women, old and young, and we give examples about children. Today we have a new example, a companion from the generation, the first generation of Islam, a companion that had lived at the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's a very important key figure in the history of Islam. He's the first caliph, the first ruler who came after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'm quite sure that now you know that he is Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu was known among the people who lived at that time that he is a man of wisdom. So people used to go to him to consult him in their problems, to ask him for some advice before Islam, and even after Islam he was very well trusted by people. And now in the early years of Islam, here was the situation where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as we know, there's a very famous event in the history of Islam, which is about Isra and Mi'raj, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went from Medina to Jerusalem, and from Jerusalem to the heaven, to the sky, where he has seen lots of things going on there. It was so surprising and strange event that were not perceived by people at that time. It was very difficult to believe that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would travel from Medina to Jerusalem overnight. It's a journey that takes perhaps few weeks or months. When this piece of news, let alone his ascension to the heaven. So this was a situation when the disbelievers at that time said that this is our golden opportunity. Let's seize the opportunity, let's take it and go to one of those wise people like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, who all the time was known of his wisdom. They thought that once this person listens to this story and hears about it, he would definitely disbelieve in Muhammad, because it was unbelievable at that time. They didn't have trains, they didn't have cars, they didn't have airplanes, they didn't have any means that would make a person able to travel such a distance in a very short time. So they went and met Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and explained the situation to him. It was unbelievable. It was difficult for any person at that time to believe a story like this. And they narrated the story to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they were waiting for his answer. Now let's see what happened at that time. They companion of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, used a very, very good logic. He said a statement that shocked his components and shocked the disbelievers at that time. He said this statement, "In kana qad qala faqad sadaq." Had Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said so, it means it happened and I trust him. He's always faithful. They were shocked. How could you believe such a thing? Now, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu was in this situation, either to reject this story and say that it's impossible to happen, and this is option number two, of course, because based on the logic of human being, based on the circumstances at that time, based on the availability of technology at that time, it was impossible to accept this. And still, he had the other option, which is option number one, to accept this because this had been said by a messenger. So this was the condition. Had it been said by Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the implication is Muhammad is a messenger of God, and a messenger of God would never ever lie. So whatever he said, even if it is against your brain and against your thinking, because your brain and your thinking and your education is very limited, it cannot grasp everything, therefore I would accept it if he said it, because he's a messenger, and whatever he said is from Almighty Allah. This is option number one. The situation was very difficult to perceive. And nowadays, when some people would say that, okay, the people went to the moon and they landed on the moon, and some people may not perceive this easily, but when they see the technology that's available, yes. But at that time, it was very difficult, more difficult even than this situation, because there was no technology that would help Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to do this. However, if Muhammad said so, I will accept it. And this is the spirit of Islam. This is the essence of Islam. I submit to whatever Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, as long as I am sure, quite sure, that it is authentic. I submit to it because I know that this is not his own saying, this is not his own doing, but it is supported by Almighty Allah. And the essence here, if I believe that Muhammad is, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the messenger of Allah, and I believed and I knew and I'm quite sure that Allah is capable of doing everything in no time. It takes no time from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to let Muhammad do this journey. It takes no time from Almighty Allah to create another planet. It takes no time from Almighty Allah to create another galaxy. It takes no time from Allah to take the oxygen from this whole planet in a second or so. It's very simple for Allah to do anything because He's the most capable, the most perfect, and the most wise. If you know all these, so it becomes very simple logic for you to believe whatever Allah says, and of course, consequently, to believe in anything that had been said by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This story reminded me of another story that had been told to me by a friend of mine, a Sudanese. He said that at that time the communism was spreading and communists were sitting, they were discussing things, and they were talking about how could the hand speak on the day of judgment, because we Muslims know that anything in you will be witness against you if you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there are many hadith of that, when the day of judgment these hands can talk, your skin can talk, anything can talk. Anyway, they were ridiculing this concept. And a janitor was coming and presenting some tea to them. And he asked them, what's strange in that? They were very educated people, so-called educated people. He said, what is strange in that? What is strange in that? What is wrong with that? If Almighty Allah commanded this tongue to speak, He can command this ear to speak. The one who made this speaks, He can make this speak. The one who makes this speak can make this speak, can make anything speak. What is so difficult in that? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the creator of this. He, just by a simple command, He can do that. What is so difficult about that? So now you can see that when the faith, when the belief is deeply rooted, is implanted in the heart of a Muslim, it becomes very easy for him to believe in al-ghayb, in the unseen, as long as he or she is quite sure that this is said by Almighty Allah or His Messenger. You can see the chain of ideas, the logic here, the simple logic here. Allah is capable of doing anything, so He can do anything. The one who created the sun can create another sun. The one who made the sun to come from the east, He can make it come from the west. The one who created one moon, He can create many other moons. It's so simple for Almighty Allah. But it is difficult for the unbelievers or the disbelievers to perceive this because they use wrong logic. They depend only on their education or their intellect. And this intellect is so limited. It's so limited, and therefore they fall into this trap. If they use it correctly, correct logic, they will reach the same conclusion as Abu Bakr Siddiq did, and he accepted option number one. Dear viewers, I hope you benefited from this, and inshallah, in the coming few episodes, we will continue giving other examples. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Mamduh Nuruddin Muhammad.
In this world today, there are many ways to fall from grace and to go astray. We should realize that in our lives we can make a change.